and listen to his words, his secret plan before he had to go. It's not complicated, don't need a lot of rules. This is all you need to know. It's loving God, loving each other.
My dear friends, today let us reflect on the book of Genesis, chapter 4, 1 to 15, and also the Gospel of Mark, chapter 8, verses 11 to 13. Very often we hear, we can't love God if we do not love our fellow human beings. Today's first reading gives us a very important lesson. Revolt against God leads us to sin against our human beings. That is, if we do not have love for God, we will not have true love for his people. Here the example of Cain did not find favor with God, since love for God was not in his heart. Abel, his brother, was killed by him. He did not love his brother. On the other hand, Abel was pleasing to God because of the sincerity of worship, of which Cain became jealous of his own brother Abel. That's why he killed him. Because Cain did not love God, he did not love his fellow human beings, not even his own brother. Trying to lead a good life without love for God is like trying to drive a car without fuel, without petrol or diesel, or like expecting a bulb to light up without electricity. My dear friends, let us grow in love for God, so we will grow in love for our fellow human beings too.
And the story never ends.
We tend to make it harder, build steeples out of stone.
But if we'd stop and listen,